At the tail of the African continent is a country rich in history and home to the great man, Nelson Mandela. The country has developed quickly socially and economically in recent years and has even greater plans for the future, putting it at the head of development on the continent. South Africa is known for its differing topography, natural beauty, and cultural diversity. It has a population of about 60 million people and is one of the most developed African countries. South Africa is the third biggest economy in Africa and has shown a great deal of interest in mega construction projects to become more economically and socially advanced. The country is addressing its overwhelming affordable housing needs, improving the infrastructure, keeping up with the pace of growth of technology, and reaching sustainable development goals by undertaking some of the most incredible megaprojects on the continent. The South African government has secured funding for several strategic infrastructure projects as part of its effective economic recovery plan. Today, we would take a look at the 10 most impressive megaprojects in South Africa. 10. The Lanseria Smart City. The Lanseria Smart City is aimed at creating the first post-apartheid city in South Africa based on best practice in urban sustainability and the principles underpinning the smart city. The city will be built surrounding the Lanseria International Airport, north of Johannesburg, in a project which is expected to take around 25 years to complete. Sitting in the center of the development, the airport will be the main economic driver for the city's growth. Strong residential growth in the surrounding areas is expected, which would be supported by improvements to existing roads in the area. The Lanseria Smart City will feature rainwater harvesting and solar energy to limit its carbon footprint. The city aims to move urban sustainability beyond existing paradigms of planning, engineering, and urbanization to increasingly appropriate levels of sustainability and innovation. It will be a 24-hour smart city zone that will offer retail, conference, and business facilities. It will also host the Lanseria Luxury Hotel. 9. The MOLOTO Road Project. In the Thembisihlahla municipality of Mpumalanga, the MOLOTO Road makeups will include the construction of Tweefontein and Kwaggafontein access roads. The two roads are expected to create over 600 job opportunities for the locals. Moreover, the minister said that there was also upgrading of four priority intersections in Mpumalanga, of which three were converted to traffic circles and one to a butterfly intersection. In the current financial year, three more construction work packages for Limpopo and five more for Mpumalanga will be rolled out. The parts to be upgraded on this notorious killer road, which ships over 50,000 road users daily, will be done in Limpopo and Mpumalanga. The entire road upgrade project is set to yield approximately 12,500 jobs over its five-year period. 8. The BRICS Cable Project. The BRICS Cable is a planned optical fiber submarine communications cable system that carries telecommunications between the BRICS, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. The cable was announced in 2012. The project aims to provide bandwidth around the southern hemisphere of the globe and to ensure that developing nations' communications are not all in the hands of the nations of the north. The cable is approximately 34,000 kilometers long and contains a two-fiber pair with a 12.8 Tbps/s capacity. The cable will be the third longest cable in the world by the time of its completion. It will interconnect with the WAX cable on the west coast of Africa and the EC and SECOM cables on the east coast of the continent. The BRICS cable is intended to circumvent the US and NSA spying through ports in Russia, China, Singapore, India, Mauritius, South Africa, and Brazil. It is estimated to cost $1.5 billion. Amazing, right? If you're still with us, then you're loving these interesting megaprojects in South Africa. Why don't you subscribe to our channel to get alerts when we release new content? Do well to like the video and share it with your loved ones also. Now, let's move on. 7. MOOIKLOOF Mega City. MOOIKLOOF Mega City is located off Garsentien Drive. The development has a total project value of over $8 billion and is one of the 62 Strategic Integrated Projects, SIPs, that were gazetted at the end of July. The first phase of the project is residential developments and some 50,000 sectional title units are planned. The project will also feature schools, shops, and offices. Steve Brooks from Bowen Properties says that MOOIKLOOF Mega City will be as green as possible, making it more affordable. The buildings would be fully green classified and would get solar and backwater harvesting, as well as other green features. Bowen said it plans to build an initial 16,000 apartments. This may be extended to up to 50,000 apartments. Apartment prices will range from R499,000 to R799,000. Commenting shortly after the launch of the project, SAFE President Tholo Makhayela said that black companies need to get into the entire value of supply chain management. The government should have spelled out transformation imperatives to Bowen Properties to allow it to partner with black companies in delivering such huge projects, he said. 6. The Space Infrastructure Hub, $215 million. This project falls under the digital infrastructure sector and was selected as one of the strategic infrastructure projects. The Space Infrastructure Hub is declared as SIP22, implying that it is of national importance and a priority. Estimated at $215 million, it will include satellite builds, Earth observation and space science missions, a new ground station, an expanded data segment, and a new data visualization center. In addition, the Space Infrastructure Hub also includes other projects for which separate ring-fenced funding has already been secured. The global space sector was valued at $360 billion in 2018. The African space industry is currently worth $7.37 billion and is projected to grow to over $10.29 billion in the next 5 years, according to the 2019 African Space Industry Annual Report. In a 2017-2018 study commissioned by the Department of Science and Innovation, South Africa had approximately 30 space companies in the upstream segment. SANSA is currently refining the details of each aspect of the deliverables within the Space Infrastructure Hub and will be hosting various engagement workshops with the local space stakeholders over the coming months. 5. The Square Kilometer Array Telescope. The Square Kilometer Array (SKA) is an intergovernmental radio telescope project being planned to be built in Australia and South Africa. Conceived in the 1990s and further developed and designed by the late 2010s, when completed it will have a total collecting area of approximately 1 square kilometer sometime in the 2020s. It will operate over a wide range of frequencies and its size will make it 50 times more sensitive than any other radio instrument. The SKA will be built in the Southern Hemisphere, with cores in South Africa and Australia, where the view of the Milky Way galaxy is the best in radio interference at its least. 4 precursor facilities are already operating: Cole and Meerkat and the Hydrogen Epoch of Reionization Array HERA in South Africa, and the Australian SKA Pathfinder, ASCAP and Murchison Wide Field Array, MWA, in Western Australia. 4. Durban Point Waterfront Development. The Eve Aquini Executive Committee is set to break ground on the Durban Point Waterfront Project, which will see the city's coastal skyline changed by skyscrapers and high-rise developments. According to a report by IOL, infrastructure rollout for the development is set to start in June 2016. A total of 750,000 square meters will be developed, including high-rise skyscrapers above 55 stories. Other infrastructure upgrades include the extension of the promenade and all surrounding roads, public transport networks, and water and electricity channels, and would cost $2.4 billion. The development is being headed by the Durban Point Development Company. UEM Sunrise modeled the development partly on schemes in Miami, Cairns, Copacabana, and Surfers Paradise in Australia. 3. Redstone Concentrated Solar Project. The Redstone Concentrated Solar Thermal Project is a 100 MW integrated CSP plant. The South Africa Department of Energy awarded the contract to develop the CSP project to the Consortium of Solar Reserve and Aqua Power in January 2015. Estimated at $798 million, Redstone is the first of its kind to be developed in Africa and is expected to produce 480,000 MW of clean energy a year. It is expected to electrify approximately 210,000 South African households during peak demand and is also anticipated to create more than 3,500 jobs. The project will feature thermovault technology developed by Solar Reserve, which will combine solar thermal technology with molten salt energy storage technology. The CSP technology will be capable of storing thermal energy for 12 hours, which enables the plant to generate electricity through the night in addition to daytime operations. Auxiliary infrastructure includes 2 molten salt storage tanks, air-cooled condensers, a water purification system, sewage treatment facility, evaporation pond, emergency diesel generators, electrical switchyard, step-up transformers, and associated facilities. 2. Greater Cornubia Development. Cornubia City is a new mixed-use development that broke ground in 2012 north of Durban, South Africa, between Phoenix, Ottawa, Mount Edgecumbe, and Mtanga. It is bordered to the east by the N2 freeway, to the west by regional route R102, and is 7 kilometers south of the King Shaka International Airport. The development project is a joint venture between the Eve Aquini Metropolitan Municipality and Tonga Hillet. 482 homes were constructed in 2014 of the 24,000 residential units planned for the development, 15,000 of which will be low-cost homes. Cornubia is the first proposed sustainable and fully integrated human settlement in the region and has been declared a national priority project. It comprises 1,200 hectares, with 80 hectares earmarked for industrial development and the remainder for commercial, housing, and other social and public facilities, including schools, clinics, police stations, post offices, and multi-purpose halls. The projected completion date is 2030 and is estimated at $1.7 billion. 1. The KUSILE Coal Power Plant. The 4.8 gigawatts KUSILE Power Station, which is expected to be one of the world's largest coal-fired power plants upon completion, is being constructed by Eskom Holdings SOC in Mpumalanga, South Africa. The plant adopts supercritical pressure technologies for a more efficient generation of power than standard coal-fired systems, resulting in a significant reduction in carbon dioxide emissions. The construction of the power plant began in August 2008. Units 1 and 2 were synchronized to the national grid in 2017. The third unit was synchronized by March 2019. The total planned operational life of the power plant is 50 years. The plant will generate enough electricity to power 3.5 million South African households upon the completion of all six units. In total, it would cost $8.2 billion. Thank you for staying with us till the end. We hope you enjoyed this piece. If you did, why not like the video and subscribe to our channel? Liking our videos helps us grow and reach more viewers.